Hi, I'm Travis. You're watching Curious Tangents, and you could probably hack a bank. This video can't be about that for reasons, but it's probably a lot easier than you might think. Since this video cannot be about that, let's instead talk about Bitcoin and blockchain and how that technology is gonna change the world, and also how the technology that you currently use is, in a way, selling you. Let's begin. The technology that Bitcoin uses, blockchain, was developed in 1991, when Nickelodeon was good and clothing was awful. So up until 2009, blockchain was a technology that was used pretty much exclusively to stop people from altering timestamps. This sounds incredibly simple, and in a way, it is a pretty simple process. Despite the fact that Bitcoin is the thing that gets all of the hype, blockchain is by far the bigger asset here. So in 2009, likely as a response to the institutional incompetence that had been happening, well, since the beginning of time, but especially in the years previous to 2009 and also beyond. So in 2009, likely as a response to the institutional incompetence that caused the 2008 recession, Bitcoin was created by a group called Satoshi Nakamoto. The interesting thing about Satoshi Nakamoto is Satoshi Nakamoto is just an alias. We don't actually know where this information came from. It came from a group located in Japan. Well, I say group, but it could have been an individual. It's foggy. But whoever is behind Satoshi Nakamoto were the first to apply blockchaining to something other than timestamping. And they did that to currency, and so now we have Bitcoin. Bitcoin, blockchain, and cryptocurrencies in general are incredibly disruptive to the economy as it stands. And the reason why they're disruptive is because our capitalistic state is entered a thing that's called surveillance capitalism. The existence of Bitcoin directly undermines the system, and I'll get into more of what that is in just a second. But first, let's do a thought experiment. So imagine that you exist. Shouldn't be too difficult. And imagine that every single time that you use a website, another version of you is created somewhere else. Except this version, rather than being created of flesh and blood, is made out of data, your data. And this digital version of you might know you better than you know you. Now, this digital version of you isn't just a mirror of what you are now, it's a more accurate image. I mean, do you know where you were 5 years ago on this day? Because Facebook does. How about how you were feeling on this day 5 years ago? Or maybe the little details that you posted about your spouse, who is no longer your spouse. Now imagine that every single time that you use a website, this version of you becomes a bit more accurate. The real problem with this digital copy of yourself is that you don't own it. None of us do. These things are owned by companies. And the ownership of personal data by companies is a thing that is referred to as surveillance capitalism. I am also, in a way, facilitating surveillance capitalism by producing this video. The ads that came up in front of this video, if any did, aren't random. They are there and they are tailored to you based on what YouTube and Google know about you. Bettina Warburg, researcher and author of Basics of Blockchain, gave an amazing TED talk on this. In it, she said that institutions like banks, corporations, and even the government are tools that we use to decrease uncertainty. The reason that I said that banks are easy to hack in the beginning of this episode is because a bank is a centralized entity. You only have to get into one server and you're in the entire thing. Where a bank works like a single-celled organism, blockchain is like a herd of lions. Herd of lions. It's a completely different level of complexity. Basically, blockchaining works by storing information on multiple different servers, and then the information on that server is fact-checked between them, in a way. Any discrepancy and the discrepant information is kicked out. In order to hack Bitcoin, you would need to hack every single server at the exact same time. So in short, you can't. Hacking Bitcoin is near impossible. What this means is that blockchain and any system built on top of it is trustworthy by itself. You might be asking why this is so disruptive. stick with me. Imagine a company like Amazon, one of the biggest companies that has ever existed. Like Facebook, they're not really in the business of physical products, though they do now have a few. The main thing that Amazon is actually selling is a connection. Amazon connects you, the consumer, to they, the businesses. Businesses get an increased customer basis and accessibility at a fee. Amazon collects that fee and you get products. Now, they have vastly expanded this to have things like Amazon Prime and their own products, but stick with me. Imagine a world where those businesses or those individuals didn't need a middleman. The reason that you and I use a service like Amazon primarily is because you can trust Amazon more than you can trust a random individual on the internet. But if we had a guaranteed system, a system that by its nature could not be cheated, then businesses like that matter significantly less. Amazon does still have some advantages. I mean, you could get almost anything from there, and you probably can't get anything from any individual. But let's imagine it with Facebook. Facebook made $71 billion last year, and their chief export was you. Facebook is in the business of selling ads. But if people were to say start using Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, and we continue developing the blockchain encryption technology that we are currently developing, then Facebook wouldn't have the same body of information that it does now. You would be the person who owns your digital body. And this is why this technology has given me so much hope lately. As Shoshana Zuboff, author of The Age of Surveillance Capitalism, once said, "We didn't sleepwalk into dystopia, we woke up in it." Now, blockchain may not end up being the world's most disruptive technology. It's possible that it could just be a technological integration instead. For instance, banks, though not banks in America, I might add, are already working on integrating the technology. And whenever technology seems to be disruptive, it's more likely to get suppressed. We, at this exact moment in time, have enough renewable energy to power the world. Companies today would have a vested interest in not letting this get too mainstream. If you have Bitcoin today, you're probably considered a bit edgy, like on the forefront of technology, not like edgy, but you get what I mean. But that's pretty much it for this video. I have a Discord server that you guys can follow. I have a Twitter and a Patreon, links to all of those in the description. Thank you for watching. Herd of lions. I was doing so well.